yes, when I first met Davey, I was 12 and I was taller than them as well. Davey, some great memories there. It was the league championship, your greatest memory though.
Yes, I think it's got to be, although Entrac was as good, to go to Dancaster and having to win 2-0, that was some job. And I think probably it's the greatest moment of my career.
Yeah, and would you say that also you enjoy your time in management at Kilmarnock?
Oh yes, I enjoyed all the time at Kilmarnock as a trainer, as assistant manager and as manager, because I love working with people. I took you.
Listen, I have to say, it's a bit special for me because I didn't know Davey was going to mention me on that video at all, and he didn't know I was going to be doing this presentation. And all I have to ask is, why did you never tell me when I was playing I was any good?
Anyway, you don't tell a player, you just try to keep on going.
Keep me going. But you kept me going, Davey, but it's been an absolute pleasure, not only for seeing you tonight, but also for the help you gave me, the help you gave a lot of people, the pleasure you gave a lot of people for that goal, certainly in that League One in 1965, which was fantastic. And I would now like to present you with something from the Killie Ball people who'd like to make a presentation to you. David, a time well served, tribute to you, well done. Also special, this is from David Boyd, the Shivers Brothers, the Aberlour Abundant, and that's also for you, and you've not to drink it tonight, David, okay, that's it. But fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, come on, a legend, David Sneddon.
It's great that we have young local boys like Naismith, Gary, McDonald, all coming through. We live within 10 miles of Kilmarnock. The other ones, Gordon here, Alan Robertson, John Stewart, who were all great players and came through the ranks and came locally. It would be great if Kilmarnock could breed a local team. You see all these teams with names I can't even pronounce coming from all over the world and paying a lot of money. We can't afford that. We've got to breed our own. And it's people like you who sponsor, who raise money for them, people here tonight who raise money to keep these boys going, because it's a great thing for my heart. People used to say to me, there's not enough out there for boys. And I'd say to them, right, you want to work, are you willing to spend 6 nights a week running a boys' club? What do you mean? I said, well, you've got to go to meetings, you've got to go to trainings, you've got to line the bar, you've got to wash the